Finding love can be a very time-consuming process, which is why dating sites and apps are so popular. But is this new culture of convenience dating killing the romance? Well, maybe not. Experts now say that finding love is actually quite scientific. And for more, we have a doctor of love of sorts to discuss on the panel. Please welcome lead compatibility scientist for eHarmony, Johnathan Beaver. It is a jungle out there, I can say on behalf of all of my gorgeous single female friends.
Hot, sexy jungle.
It is. In fact, this beautiful woman had to go on a national dating show, The Bachelor,
to find love. That's right, I heard you were on
The Bachelor. Yeah. Didn't work out very well, but, you know, gave it a good red hot go.
It did. But what, in your opinion, why isn't swipe dating like Tinder working for people?
Well, those swipe-based apps, there's not a lot of effort that goes into the sign-up process. So you're getting a lot of people who are just doing it for fun. So it kind of makes it really hard to find someone that is looking for the same thing that you are.
So you, Johnathan, eHarmony did a live social experiment this week.
Right.
With a maths formula. What on earth is that?
Well, so we wanted to put our algorithm to the test in a live situation. Wow. So we wanted to hold a speed dating event, and we had over 600 applicants to this one night event. And I had to narrow down the pool to 40, and yeah.
How did you do that though?
How does the algorithm work in real life? How do you match people?
Well, it's all based on a lot of research that we've done over the past 18 years. We've studied over 500,000 couples over the past 18 years. So we know what really goes into making a long-term relationship work.
What does? Mm. Is it A equals MC squared? Or what is
I need help.
5'7".
Well, there's a lot that goes into it, but I'd say the overall message is finding someone who shares similar values, personality traits, and relationship preferences as you do.
Right. So this is so funny because if you put my husband and I both on paper, you would go, there's no way that those two would work together because we're vastly different. But in a way, our differences complement each other. Mm. So, you know, in real life, that's the way it works. How do you do that through a computer program?
Well, through our research, we have seen, you know, what works and what doesn't work. And from the results of this research, we basically construct our matching algorithms to set people up that would kind of emulate what we've seen were the happiest and most successful couples.
So in fact, the whole idea that opposites attract is a myth. You're more likely to have, well, obviously there are exceptions and we'll see how Sarah's marriage works out.
I'm the same with Petey, my husband. But
I think though, and I reckon it's the same with you too, Sarah, we share the same approach on sort of values and those sorts of the big questions.
Right. Yeah.
And that would be the same, I reckon, with you and Tom. And those big picture questions.
Yeah, that's true.
But agree.
Sarah, we talk about the spark between people. Did you have that, the both of you, as soon as you met Tom?
Yes.
And with Petey, you
loved
him.
Oh, yeah. Well,
from the beginning.
Yes, I badgered him.
and you know what, Denise? I have never been attracted to redheads. So if I had met my husband on a dating app, I would have. If I had seen his photo, I would have.
But
being in his orbit
made
me feel something. And you know, I'm a sucker for redheads.
Can I ask you though? Can an algorithm equate that spark though?
Yeah.
Well, that's what we were trying to do with this event that we held this week. So our research has really focused on what creates a long-term relationship so that's so wonderful. And we also have a separate system where we optimize who is going to communicate with each other on our site. Mm. But we really haven't looked at what creates that great first date. You know, when you meet them in person finally, you know, you just can't get enough of them.
So the spark is still
I love
a mystery.
That feeling.
Right, so that's what we were testing with our compatibility stuff. We wanted to see if our measures, as they are now, will predict that spark.
And did you get the spark when you tested it in real life?
Well, I'm still analyzing the data.
Ah.
It's been a fun week for me.
It's interesting to say, because we asked you, you're not allowed to use the system, your own system, because you've got access to all the people. But you've had so many successes. And you know somebody, Siri.
One of my brother's little friends met his gorgeous wife over eHarmony. And it's really interesting too, because there has been for a long time a bit of a weirdness about online dating, but I think this whole new generation of people looking for love,
that's how it's out the window.
It's what they do. Mm-hmm. It's completely normal.
You've got to get into the algorithm.
Oh, God.
There it is.
If you want real experts, eHarmony has over 200,000 relationship matches in Australia and counting. Johnathan Beaver, you've been wonderful to talk to.
Yeah. Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you.